audio, so say whatever you want to say. Just remember.
I'm a big Jack Bruce fan. You know Jack Bruce?
The comedian?
No,
Lenny Bruce.
He was a musician. He was in Cream.
Oh, of course.
The bass
on our way to Edinburgh Castle.
The bass player. I met him once.
Really?
Many years ago.
I met him too. He's one of my favorite musicians.
Yeah, yeah.
He's got a new album out.
We're on the top of the double-decker bus now.
Yeah,
he's Which is why you're getting good deal.
Right. One of the first rock gods.
So Sean, point out the sites if there's any to see. So that my viewing audience can...
There's a leap, and on the left you've got warehouses. These are all the now apartments, and they're very expensive.
They are, really?
Yeah, they're quite expensive.
How expensive is expensive?
For Edinburgh. Well, Edinburgh's quite expensive for Scotland. But these are very very upmarket. You get a lot of boutiques and fashion houses. And
so about £600 a month, or?
I'm not sure what you pay to rent them on. You got a lot of niche restaurants and stuff right here now.
So these are like converted commercial buildings.
Yes, converted warehouses, yeah. Originally, still in working class area. On the left, you see the shore, as it's called, which is the main port of the original medieval port. A lot of very expensive restaurants.
This is where we went yesterday. We saw this. So that's just a restaurant right there.
Somehow I thought that was the Queen's boat.
No. That's what I thought was the Queen's boat, but no.
No.
I don't think the Queen will be.
I know, but when the woman.
Can you see her getting in that dinghy?
This woman was trying to explain it to me. She's going, "You saw it when you went past," but and I'm like, "No, I don't think that's it."
But that's it. That's just the original. If you look to the right, you'll see the shore buildings. This is the original medieval port. This is where Mary Queen of Scots landed when she came back from France.
Oh, is that right? Hi, Mark.
Reminds me of Amsterdam for some reason.
Yeah, very, it does a little bit, yeah.
The Guildhall buildings and everything.
We're starting to learn where things are now that it's a couple days we've been lost in the city.
You've been lost.
You've been lost too.
Well, so.
Sort of. Oh, anybody listening to this, we've been very lost.
That's not true. We've done all right, considering.
We managed to find our way back, but.
Besides, getting lost is part of the fun.
Yeah, that's true. Getting lost is part of the fun. So Mary Queen of Scots came here.
She landed more or less on this shore, on this, well, it wouldn't have been a concrete quayside, obviously, but.
No.
It was this.
When she came from Scott, when she came from. France,
came from France
after marrying the
Dauphin.
Is that how you say it? Dauphin?
Dauphin.
She never had a. Yeah, it looks like the word dolphin. Sorry, guys. We're at cobblestones here. Things. But he died. He was a very sickly young man.
Yeah, I believe so. Yeah.
Nobody expected him to live.
That's a border collie that can't wait to get wherever he's going.
Oh yeah, look at the border collie. Border collie.
I think
Fight
all
some
these
tires.
Border collies are trying to go after tires. We just saw a video. There's village that they've had a vandal. Like 24 tires have been punctured, and it was a border collie attacking the tires. It was just going after them.
Look at him.
He wants
so
to go
excited.
For his run. Where's the sheep?
Where's the sheep? So now, the stones here are not original in the roads, right?
Yeah, the cobbles are very rich. Well, they've been relayed probably several times. But yeah, there's many streets that still have cobbles. And that's what all streets had until they had tarmac.
And they keep them because it keeps
tourists.
Tourists, and it keeps the speed down, probably.
Yeah, but that's amazing. Nice. A lot of people complain when they dig them up, so.
Huh. Let's see what else. Oi.
Oi?
I gotta start saying I. This bus service here in Edinburgh is amazing. Oh, look, somebody who doesn't have a white windows. They're green. I thought that wasn't allowed.
There's no preservation order. Some houses have a preservation order. You mentioned all about decorate the outside in any way that's not original. You can't build on it, you can't put an extension or anything like that. You have to paint the floor to the same colors.
Right. We've noticed there's these wiggly lines. They're painted on the road, the white lines. And somebody told us that means that you're definitely not to park there. But then I'm seeing them in the middle of people's, of the lanes.
Ah, you mean they're called zigzags. They're when you have a zebra crossing, which is the cross, you know, the black and white place to cross.
Uh-huh.
You're not allowed to park in those zigzags at all. Because they restrict the view of people crossing the road.
Oh, okay.
That's what they're for. So. Now we're coming up to the foot of the walk, or foot of the walk as it's called, the bottom of Leith Walk.
Oh, this is the...
Yeah. The main thoroughfare between Leith and Edinburgh.
Leith. And how do you spell Leith? It's not L-E...
L-E-I-T-H.
L-E-I-T-H. Leith.
There's a tongue twister about Leith. I don't know if you're aware of it, are you?
No.
I can never say this properly. The Leith police dismissed us. So if ever you get arrested by the police in Leith and they dismiss you, they say the Leith police dismissed us. I can't say that. Maybe we have to be Victoria on the statue.
Oh, there's Victoria. Hi, Victoria. How you doing? She's looking herself. Very stiff.
This have you ever seen a film of Train Spotting?
Train Spotting?
Yeah, a very famous film. It's made by Danny Boyle, who made the film director Danny Boyle made it. It's set in Leith, and it's about a bunch of heroin addicts in Leith.
I can't imagine.
I would recommend it. Get it on Netflix or something.
Yeah, see, is this a Polish area? Because we were down here yesterday, and there was like Polish restaurants and Polish this and that. I just saw another one.
Yeah, no, there's a lot of Polish people now live in the UK because we have freedom of movement across Europe.
Uh-huh.
Basically, citizens of any country in the European Union can live in another country without immigration laws. There's a lot of Polish people came to the UK. So, of course, some enterprising Poles have set up their own restaurants and grocers catering to those guys. There's not particularly a Polish area, but there may well be some, and they've formed a business in that area.
Hmm.
It's much bigger down south. There are some in Edinburgh. There's a lot of people working there. You know, in the building trade and things like that, they're very popular.
So
Easter Road, which is very close to my heart.
See, here's these little lines here.
Yeah, it means north. You see, there's a crossing. See the pedestrian crossing?
Right.
The traffic light. So it means you're not allowed to block the view of the crossing. Over there, that's Leith Lakes, the green area. They reckon that's where the oldest golf course in the world is, on Leith Lakes.
Really?
Wow. You play golf, that's Mary Queen of Scots supposed to have played on there, but then she probably did everything.
Yeah, she's like George Washington in our area. George Washington slept here.
William Wallace, Mary Queen of Scots, and Bonnie Prince Charlie.
Now, where we live, it's very golf. Lots of golf.
A lot of golf.
We have a lot of the big tournaments. The AT&T, it's incredibly golf haven.
Gotcha.
It's like Scotland and then Pacific Grove.
Uh-huh.
Pebble Beach is what it's called.
Oh, right, I know what you mean, yeah.
Yeah, so we're very... But none of us here play golf.
I did when I was younger, but I'm not particularly a fan of it. This is Easter Road, not named after the time of the year. It's named after Easter because it's the opposite of Wester. So it's on the east side of the city.
Oh, Easter, Wester. Okay, yeah, gotcha.
So you have roads and the Wester Hills. You get towns called Easter something or Wester something. And coming up on the left in a minute, you'll see the top of Easter Road Stadium, which is the home of my soccer team.
Your soccer team?
Yeah, I have a season ticket there. I go to the games every fortnight.
Every 2 weeks. Interesting.
And do you like sports, or do you?
No, not really.
Not a big sport person.
We certainly don't follow soccer.
Not many Americans do, too.
No, and American football, we're not... It's very popular in America, obviously.
Of course, yeah.
But Mark and Sterling and I are not interested in it. So it says Easter Road signs.
Yeah, Easter Road.
As opposed to Wester Road.
Yeah.
Ah, I was wondering about that.
It's nothing to do with you know, the religious festival this time of year. It's just simply it's on the eastern side of the city. You can just see Salisbury Crags popping up. You see the cliff?
The what?
The cliff. See the cliff face in the head of you?
Salisbury Crags.
That's Salisbury Crags.
Arthur's Seat, right?
It's part of Arthur's Seat, yeah. Well, Arthur's Seat is the mountain. Salisbury Crags is that cliff, flat cliff head that spins off of it. There is a walk, you'll see it, just to the base of the cliff face at the top of the ramp. There's a small path.
That's where we're going to go. The what is it, Dalkeith Road? We'll get us
Dalkeith.
Yeah.
Dalkeith Road. There's a town called Dalkeith. It's just the road going to Dalkeith.
Yeah.
So the people here have to keep their windows pretty much the same, right? Color white. And
brown.
Nobody's allowed to paint the
I think it's just
upper
standards,
floors.
Really. I think it's just what people do. You just paint them white.
The hotel that we're staying at told us that
Susan
that
would
you
have
can't.
A hard time going along with that.
No, I like the white. I like it. And I'd like it to look all standard and well measured. He said that it was really difficult to get permits to change the look of your outside of your building.
Some buildings, yes, because they say they'll have a preservation order on them. And that's basically where the city council will say there are different grades. There's grade 1, 2, and 3. Depends on how historical your house or your building is. Some buildings will have a grade 1, which means you're not allowed to change almost anything in it. Which could be good and bad. I mean, it's good that it puts your value up, but bad, I mean, you can't change your house around.
Right. And these are mostly apartments?
Yeah, these are
or
all
condominiums?
Or sometimes they're called stairs. If you live in a stair, it means you live in a tenement building. And there'll usually be, you see the door in the middle, like that red door. There'll be a staircase in the middle going up to the upper levels.
So you usually would have like an apartment of some sort with one or two or three bedrooms off of it.
If you look to the left now, you'll see the top of the stadium. That's straight there.
Oh, I see it. How modern it looks.
Yeah, it's only been rebuilt over the last 10 years.
So what's the name of your team? So
Hibernian.
Who?
Hibernian.
Hibernian?
Yeah, it's like the Irish the Latin for Ireland, Hibernia.
Oh. And people follow these teams because they were, like, from their youth, or their...
Yeah, I mean, I grew up being a Hibs fan. They're called the Hibs, and most people know them as the Hibs.
And they're...
There are two teams in Edinburgh. There's Hibs and there's Hearts. Hearts are the other team. There's a big rivalry between them.
In America, we see that you guys fight over these teams. Like, you go to a soccer... match.
Well, actually, if you
football.
Look down there, you'll see a sign that says Hip Supporters Club. No members welcome.
Oh, so that's the anti you.
No, that's the Hips.
Oh, you're the anti Hips. Yeah. Okay, gotcha. So you guys fight over it. Well, I guess they do in America a little bit too, but.
It's exaggerated, but it happened when I was younger. In the 70s and 80s, it was quite bad. But nowadays, it's more or less dead, isn't it?
Just for fun.
Yeah, there's a lot of talking going on, a lot of singing and shouting. There are certain areas of town you might not go in wearing a scarf of the wrong colour.
Oh.
My team is green, the other team is a sort of dark red. And unfortunately about half of my family are one colour and the other half are
dark. That's true in America too.
Christmas and weddings and things are fun.
There's a cat rescue. Oh, we could go in there and pet the cats. I miss my cats.
Probably not got cats in it, it'll just be a wee charity show.
Oh! Well, we thought we found a laundromat the other day. I saw it was a wash bar. And I thought, oh, there's a laundromat that's perfect. And then we drove by the day later and it's a bar. So we thought, oh, good thing we didn't bring our laundry here because I thought it was a laundromat.
You'll have a job finding them. I don't know where this one is.
We found one.
You did, right?
Yeah, where is it, Mark? The laundromat we found?
Leaf Walk.
Leithwalk.
Lower end of Leithwalk.
It's about 4 miles from our
well, that's where we
from
went.
Our hotel.
The walk, yeah.
Oh, it was insane. We went on, and Mark kept asking the bus driver, "Are we almost there yet?" He goes, "No, I'll let you know. I haven't forgotten." We kept going and going and going. He says, "I think they're playing a prank on us as Americans." Because the woman at the hotel said it's 4 stops away. So we got into the bus, and he says, "No, it's 4 miles away."
Yeah, that's probably more accurate, yeah.
And then we went, it felt like maybe 6 or 7 miles. So we really do think that they were just playing with the Americans. And then
well,
we got off.
We're going to be doing laundry again. Really
and then we happen. Then we got off the bus, and he says, "It's right there on your left." And so we got off, and we went, and it's not on our left, it's on the other side, on the right. And Mark nearly killed himself by trying to get out in the traffic. He looked the correct way the first time, stopped, and then looked the wrong way. The rest, oh, I was like, "Oh my gosh, I'm going to just, I can't handle this." Sterling's not ready, not
Sterling
too happy about me either. No, Sterling here is saying, this Sterling is saying that, he's like, no. Oh, and these Toilette signs? I thought it was toilet signs. Because it's just missing the I. And I noticed you guys call them toilets here, not bathrooms or...
Yeah, you
everything's toilets.
Toilet or bog is probably the other one.
Bog?
Bog.
I never heard that. So I kept seeing these... You know, you're just glancing.
Yeah.
I fill in the in the letters with my mind, and I especially kept saying, "Oh, there's space. Toilets everywhere. There's toilets all over the place. This is great. This town is so user-friendly for tourists. We can find a bathroom anywhere." And then it dawned on me after a while, it's just missing the I to let. We say for sale.
But to let means to rent, rather than it's not for sale, it's to rent.
Oh, well, we would say for rent.
Just the thing is a to let. Yeah.
Or a toilet. I bet you they have a toilet in there somewhere.
Sure.
And say, "Hey, if I'm looking at maybe letting your place, can I check out the toilet while I'm in here?" Look at it's starting to bloom. Isn't that beautiful? Look at these trees. Very beautiful. Yeah, lots of blossoms. I can't wait to go see the botanical gardens. I think that's going to be gorgeous.
That's a botanical. That's another place I haven't been to for many years.
Oh, we're hoping to go there this weekend.
Not far from them when I was a kid. We used to go there quite often.
And there's buses everywhere. And I don't know if people watching can see this, but, well, actually, I don't see it here right now. But the signs are really good at, on one side of the sign, it'll tell you what time the train is due. And it's a computerized...
The bus.
Yeah, the bus. It's a computerized sign that will constantly fluctuate the time. Like, it'll count down the minutes till the next bus comes through.
So you don't have long to wait, yeah.
Yeah, oh, it's amazing. Very, very, very quick. Bus service.
So all the buses have like GPS chips in them, so they know where they are at any time.
That's what I thought, because it updates it so fast. Now, Iceland,
America is like, well, if your bus hasn't shown up, either you're late or it's late, but
right.
You don't know which.
Yeah, it's not very. I don't know about the bigger cities in America. Now, Iceland is a little like a grocery store.
Yeah, it's mainly just frozen food. They have a lot of big freezers in there, so people buy it. I don't say down market, but they're certainly inexpensive, shall we say, frozen food.
Okay.
Like your ready meals, as we call them. You know, a TV dinner type thing, I think you call
it. Oh, yeah, TV dinners.
Uh-huh. Yeah, not ready meals. So you buy a ready meal curry or lasagna or a...
There's another very happy dog that wants to get out and walk.
I have a black lab myself, but he
doesn't move, so... Aww.
Slow down and get so that me and you both talk.
Now, what are we starting to look at now here? This is beautiful in front of us.
So coming up to the east end of the city. This is Royal Terrace, I think it's called. I can never remember. Oh, Carlton Terrace, that's it.
Is that a government building up there?
No, it's the houses.
Oh, it's beautiful.
Expensive houses, good houses.
And you call them houses even though they don't seem to be standalone.
A house generally is standalone. They are standalone. A lot of them, some of them might be apartments, but most of them are standalone. You'll have a house, it's got 3 floors.
Mm-hmm.
They were originally built as one single house in each. Two windows together, or maybe 3 windows would be one house. Two windows together and you'll have terrace houses. But it's obviously these are apartment buildings, or flats as we call them.
So is this Arthur's Seat we're looking at?
Arthur's Seat is the big hill behind the tree.
other seat.
Yeah,
okay.
That's off the seat.
And this is some cliff over here.
Salisbury Crag. Do you see the path going up at the base of the crag?
Oh, yeah, yeah, where the yellow flag is.
Yeah, yeah, that's Holyrood House there with the flag. That's the Queen's
Palace. That's where we were yesterday.
Oh, you've been to Holyrood?
Oh, Holyrood. Holyrood?
Holyrood yeah. Palace, yeah.
Yeah, we went down as far as Holyrood and then we turned around and came back. And
well, you didn't go into the building, then?
No, I we were really hungry. And there didn't look to be any places to eat down there.
Abbey Hill. So at the back of Holyrood House, which you see with the flag, that's the building. It's the old Holyrood Abbey, which was the original building, which is derelict.
This is construction. What's going on here?
Building something.
Something?
Don't know what.
You're supposed to know these things.
That's not historical, you see.
Oh, okay. Chatham's entrance.
Chatham's. Building company probably called Chatham's. That's the main East Coast main line. That's the railway line. It's the main London to Edinburgh main railway line. Just going under. There's a duck there.
Duck, everyone.
So Carlton Hill is right there?
Carlton Hill.
Carlton.
Yeah, you're right, yeah.
Oh, it's interesting. It's very modern in here.
It's a small building. That's called Queen Mary's Bath House.
Queen Mary's Bath House, right ahead of us, folks.
It's probably not a bathhouse, but it's known as Queen Mary's Bath House.
And a bath house is where she actually takes a bath, not where she uses the toilet.
Yes, that's what the bath house is supposed to be, but it's probably not that. It's never a bathhouse, but it's just known as that.
What's in it?
I'm not sure. It's a historical building of some sort. I think it's probably a gatehouse of some sort. It just happened to have survived.
Oh, beautiful.
Many builders and nobody knocked down, so it survived.
So I noticed there's tons of daffodils.
Yes, it's a daffodil time of year.
Very, very, very prominent here. Oh, this is the ugly Parliament building that's that right. Everybody was really upset about.
I like it.
You do?
Yeah, that's how
this is modernized.
I
heard that there was a lot of flack about how unpopular it was.
It was one of these that, you know, when politicians get hold of a project, and they kind of ruin it.
So we're on the mile, right? This
Royal
is called
Mile.
Royal Mile. And this is a mile to Edinburgh Castle.
It's between the palace and the castle, was about a mile.
So we're getting a good overview of the city here. All the people who are watching will be able to get a good view of what to expect in Edinburgh.
A lot of these buildings are actually new because they knocked down slums, and a lot of this was just mostly
Victorian
slums. And that, the white building, is that was kept, that's Murray House. That was kept in the original Parliament.
And you'll notice a lot of closes. Here's Brown's Close, that means an alley. We've learned.
Yes.
We've gone down a few of them yesterday.
They're not as wide as an alley, though.
They're just like the back street of something, yeah.
That yellowy building is a museum of childhood. It's definitely worth a visit.
Museum of childhood?
Oh, the Museum of Edinburgh.
Oh, no, we've been there. We've been there yesterday. Mark conned
some
guy into going into... Well, we were kind of...
You found this back alley where there are all these old stones that you weren't allowed to go in.
Oh, this is the Queen's.
Unsafe.
This is the Queen's church when she comes to.
There's a weird shop.
Well, we had a royal wedding up there last year. I thought, like year before, I think it was one of the Queen's granddaughters got married in that church.
Yeah, that's the Queen. When she comes to Edinburgh, that's where she goes to church. That's what they said.
That's the toll booth, which is the old prison.
Oh, it's a prison.
Well, the toll booth was originally a prison.
Yeah, so we did this yesterday. We walked down and up.
It's very touristy, unfortunately, in Canongate.
It was kind of nice. I really enjoyed the...
You wouldn't get many Edinburgh people down here.
Oh, is that?
It's mostly touristy.
Well, we got to do that kind of thing. That's our job.
No, that's fine.
But it was. We went up to the cathedral at the very top.
St. Giles, yep.
St. Giles, yeah. Beautiful inside.
You know that the crown goes back to the 1400s on top. It's a very old building.
Hmm.
And it was lucky it survived the Reformation. Very long. They just destroyed most of the interior, but they managed to at least keep the building intact, which is one thing.
There's a well here. I think there's the first well or something like that. Oh, we went down into the World's End.
You know why it's called the World's End?
Because there was a big fight here, right?
No, there was two girls who were killed here 40 years ago. I saw that in the papers.
Originally, this was the boundary between Canongate and the city of Edinburgh. Canongate was a separate town.
Oh, okay.
So the border was here, and supposedly you get to the World's End, you get to the end of Edinburgh.
Okay, here's Jeffrey Street.
Look, those are for sale.
Oh, they do have sale signs.
The for sales are for lonely houses. You would rarely buy a shop. You would normally rent a shop, but you would buy a house or a flat or an apartment.
So what would it be for per month or something like that? Just for fun.
Those are for sale, honey.
I really wouldn't know. I can imagine £1,000 a month would be unreasonable, £800 a month.
So now these are people in most of the buildings above us. These are home people are living in, or like a business somebody's rented out for the.
They're probably homes. Some are office buildings.
Oh, there's John Knox's home. We went into that yesterday. John Knox. We saw that, and I remembered my couple bits of history about him and Mary Queen of Scots and how they didn't really get along.
No, they didn't. They called Mary and Elizabeth and
what was that, the woman
monstrous
thing?
Monstrous Regiment of Women.
Monstrous Regiment of Women. I remember that.
You certainly know your history.
It's coming back to me a little bit. I read a lot about it, but I get so confused.
Oh, I can understand.
There was a Sherlock Holmes book.
Conan Doyle was born in Edinburgh.
Oh, is he really born
here? I think Conan Doyle, the writer, was born in Edinburgh. Very famous Edinburgh citizen.
I think it's that pub.
Conan Doyle. Yeah, there's a pub called the Conan Doyle. It's not a bad pub. I've been in it several times. It's not far from where I used to work. I used to go there sometimes after work.
We found the Frankenstein bar. We found that. That was quite interesting. We had we met Ben and Peter, the speaker, for the other night, and a pub called Under the Stairs.
Yep.
And then we went to a pub where it was called. Mr. Lincoln, help me out with the. I can't remember the name of it.
Banshee's Labyrinth.
Oh, Banshee's Labyrinth. That was
left, yeah.
That was quite interesting. Yeah.
So is there a pub?
Oh, we ate
Robert
there,
Lewis
Bella Italia.
Pub or something. And somehow I remember that the last time I was here. Maybe it's named after one of the characters.
You know, particularly Deacon Brodie's.
That must be it. Yeah. Now that's from the Body Snatchers, right?
Yeah. No, Deacon Brodie's was. He was the character that allegedly Stevenson based Jekyll and Hyde.
Oh, Jekyll and Hyde, okay.
And Deacon Brodie was a well-respected local councillor by day, but by night he was a housebreaker.
Oh, yeah.
He was a locksmith, and he would make people look, you know,
true story,
and then get a copy and then break into the houses.
It was a true story then, right?
Well, he was true. Deacon Brodie was definitely true. And he supposedly had built the new gallows for the city.
Yeah.
And of course, he was eventually on the same gallows that he'd built.
That's great.
So we ate there, Bella Italia. Correct?
Yeah.
Yep.
I'll go off at the next stop, I think. Sorry. Just walk up the long market.
Okay. Oh, bus drivers or something else. I don't know how they manage. Okay, we gotta go down. Turning off.